Welcome to another Paccar Powertrain Knowledge Minute on valve adjustment. This video covers Paccar MX-11 EPA 2017 only. This includes engine model years 2016 through 2021. For safety reasons, the battery should be disconnected as you begin the valve adjustment procedure. This will also protect vital electrical components. In most MX-11 applications, you will need to remove the air cleaner assembly and most of the induction piping. With these out of the way, you will have clear access to the valve cover. Loosen the bolts to fasten the valve cover to the valve train casing. Then remove the valve cover and set it aside until it is time to replace the gasket and reinstall. One of the Paccar MX engine special tools is the 1903-018 engine cranking tool. This should be used to align the appropriate marks on the flywheel for adjusting the valves. On this engine, the crankshaft will have to be rotated 6 times in 120-degree increments to adjust all the valves. There are 3 stop positions on the flywheel and front pulley related to adjusting the valves. These are 1-6, 2-5, and 3-4. You can position the crank in any of these 3 positions to start the valve adjustment process. Once you stop on a mark, you will need to adjust the valves on whichever of the 2 cylinders has no open valves. The MX-11 is a dual overhead cam engine. When you have arrived at one of the stopping points on the flywheel, you will adjust the intake and exhaust valves for the cylinder that has both valves closed, and you will adjust the engine brake for the companion cylinder. On the MX-11, the adjustment point for both the intake and exhaust valve is between the rocker foot pad and the valve bridge. In the video, the technician stopped rotating the crankshaft in position 3-4. Since both valves are open on cylinder 3, he adjusted the intake and exhaust valves on cylinder number 3. Be sure to check the adjustment each time you move either the adjusting screw or the lock nut. Even though you take care to make sure there is no movement, small movements can affect accuracy. As you complete the adjustment on each valve, make sure to torque the lock nut to the proper specification. At the time this video was produced, that was 38 Newton meters, which is about 28 foot-pounds. However, be sure to check Rapido as these values can change. After adjusting the intake and exhaust valves on a cylinder, and before rotating the crankshaft to the next stop point, the next step is to adjust the engine brake on the companion cylinder. Since on this engine the intake and exhaust valves were adjusted on cylinder number 3, the engine brake on cylinder number 4 should now be adjusted. Rapido has a detailed table on which valves and which engine brakes should be adjusted at which stop point on the crankshaft as it is rotated. Remember, the crankshaft will have to be rotated 120 degrees 6 times to adjust all the valves and all the engine brakes. As a final step in the process, reconnect the batteries. It is recommended that you follow the truck manufacturer's recommendations on the torque spec for the battery connections.